We had met a couple times before, and I was friends with Angela, so we already sort of knew each other a little bit.
You know, it all happened so quickly because, you know, the day that Angela told us about her final decision that she wanted to step down as a singer was the same time she was urging us, you know, to continue. She said, you know, you guys really should keep the band going. I know how much you love doing it. You've got great new music. You have an amazing fan base out there. I don't see a reason why you should stop just because I'm quitting. These are her words. And she also suggested, at least that's a possible, you know, possibility. That was her recommendation. It all happened very quickly. We established contact with Elisa. She came up to Sweden. We worked on the old material, rehearsed 20 of the old songs in the rehearsal room. We collaborated on new music that we had and recorded a little bit of the new stuff as well on a demo. So it all happened very quickly. So we didn't really consider anybody else, a woman or man.
To be honest, I don't really feel like I'm like replacing her because she's pretty irreplaceable, you know. So I sort of just feel like, you know, I mean, the way it all happened made it really a smooth transition for me. You know, like Angela wanted this, and then I, when it was suggested to me, I was like, yeah, I also want this. This would be cool. So, yeah, I mean, obviously it's a big challenge.
Always fighting. Yeah, I think it's, you know, it is a strong title, I think. But it's also, it's about really the life, you know, that war can be, is really the life that you live. You know, you go through life and you face a lot of struggles. You face a lot of, you know, there can be a lot in the way of you're trying to remain an individual and hold on to your personality and who you want to be and what you want to do. Hold on to your individuality, your creativity, personality. It can be difficult because there are a lot of obstacles in the way. I think, you know, I think even from the day you're born, you're kind of, it's easier, I think, if everybody was the same for some people, you know, for society it's like easier to control in a way. So I think that's what it's about. I wrote that on guitar, actually, believe it or not, and then very simple idea on a guitar, just these notes repeating, and then in a pattern, and then I took that actually to, we collaborated with a conductor arranger on this album, so there's real orchestra on the intro and also on the three of the songs. I don't know anything about arranging orchestra or strings. Mm-hmm. I just told him what I said, can you make this kind of sound like the Omen movie or something? And he added all the other elements and it came together. Pretty cool way to start the album, I think. Yeah, lots of new collaborations, which obviously makes it sound very fresh, I think. Nick definitely helped me shape the songs into what they are. We've sort of struck up a very good relationship, a guitar relationship, as well as a personal one. So it's a lot of guitar playing on the album, and I think we really pushed each other, really. Not in a competitive way, but we just wanted the album to be more intense. As intense as possible from a guitar perspective and songwriting perspective. And then, once Elisa was in the picture, it just went on to a whole new level.
It was a bit of both, but mostly together, you know. Like, I wrote the lyrics and the vocal arrangements for five of the songs, and Michael did five songs. But we also bounced ideas off of each other, you know. So if he had a better idea than I had, I would gladly take it, you know, and vice versa. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's certainly the most progressive piece of music that I've ever worked on. It was the first one I started writing, actually. I was going back 2011, maybe, to the early 2012. it was the first piece of music that I worked on, that was the new music. It was also the last piece of music that we finished, because it was just, couldn't really get it, you know, it was just so many things going on, and it progressed and grew and grew and grew. And in the end, we didn't really know where we were going with it. It was kind of like, how is this just
cool? I just had so many ideas.
Yeah, is this just a cool piece of music, or is it actually a song that we can put on the album? Should it be an instrumental? No, I think we should have lyrics to tie it all together and make it a song. But we didn't really, it was like really difficult to put together in a way, because we don't really usually write sort of extended songs that go into, and that song's kind of like a little mini epic bit of a journey. But in the end, it came together really well. In the beginning, we only came to Paris and played a show in Paris, and we'd go back over to Germany or wherever, you know. But then we started working with a new promoter over here, and he's really been instrumental in putting us in a lot of French cities, and nobody's happier about that than us, because it's proven to be like one of our main sort of, one of our favorite places to come and play. It's just a relationship that we developed over the years, I guess. But it's really kind of been growing and growing. And I think now with the addition of Elisa and this new album, I mean, it's obviously like a new chapter of the band, a new era. Hellfest. No, we're not playing Hellfest. Why not? I don't know.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
But you know, we're playing Wacken, we're playing, that's another a very big one. Hellfest, I'd love to play Hellfest again. We've played it a few times. Maybe next year.
Yeah, I mean, obviously I want to sing the songs from the new album, but I also love all, you know, I love all the other Arch Enemy songs that I know too, and the ones that I've practiced so far are a lot of fun to perform. I'm looking forward to performing them, you know, on stage. I think I would have to say Enemy Within and We Will Rise. Merci beaucoup pour le support. Je suis très fière de War Eternal. Nous sommes vraiment, vraiment contentes avec l'album. Nous avons hâte de jouer pour vous. Et finalement, moi personnellement, j'ai seulement joué à France une fois. Donc j'espère jouer de plus en plus, parce que je vois qu'il y a vraiment un bon soutien pour le métal ici. Donc merci beaucoup. J'espère que vous aimeriez War Eternal aussi.